Hi everyone, this is a video about Yaramila, but this is from the request from a viewer. Today we're going to talk about Yaramila 10-10-30. I don't own this fertilizer and I try my best to explain about this fertilizer. As usual, it has fast soluble nitrate nitrogen, about 6%, and a slow releasing ammonium nitrogen that consists of 4%. And it has a good mixture of water soluble and citrus soluble phosphorus pentaoxide. Those are the essential elements that allow your phosphorus to be dissolved in any kind of soil condition. And of course, the main focus is the 30% of potassium chloride, which is probably the highest among all the selections. And some other important elements such as boron and magnesium as well. And for this particular fertilizer, I'd like to make a comparison with the other Yaramila lineups that contain high potassium. For this fertilizer, we can see it contains probably the highest potassium compared to other lineups, and it also contains some of the trace elements. First, I would like to put the lineup 13-13-21, 12-12-17-2, and 13-11-21. Well, the similarity between these four fertilizers, as we can shown as above. Number one, they are potassium chloride centric. Four of those utilize full MOP based potash, and also focusing on the late phase of this plant, which is the fruiting stage. These layout are pretty similar to 10-10-30, except for some improvement have been implemented on these fertilizers. Number 1, they increase the potassium content by 30% and compromises nitrogen and phosphorus. As we can see in the chart, it probably holds the highest potassium chloride content, and it is a true powerhouse by delivering the maximum amount of potassium. It comes in handy during the fruiting stage of the plant, at which the plant needs a lot of potassium to absorb to increase the size of the fruit. And not just about high potassium, it also contains some decent trace elements. Trace elements such as boron and magnesium play an important role alongside with potassium. For this part, it's kindly similar to 13-11-21 because both actually have boron and magnesium. But in here, 10-10-30 is a close winner due to this high potassium content, even though it has slightly lower magnesium compared to the another one. The price point between these two fertilizers are pretty close to each other, so 10-10-30 is a better pick here. The only difference between these two is the structure of the fertilizer, which we are going to discuss as a video play along. And another one, it has a reasonable price point. Despite the fact that the price of the fertilizer has been spiked during this year, most of the farmers have been heavily affected with this unprecedented price increase. However, this fertilizer has the relatively high performance per price ratio compared to other product lineups. We calculated it with the potassium content plus the TE elements over the price that had been officially charged to the customer. It is slightly expensive, but you got extra cash to spend, then you should go for this fertilizer. The most important part is that it is designed in granular form instead of prill form. Granular form has slightly lower solubility compared to prill. As such, the granular fertilizer will last longer compared to the prill one. Therefore, this fertilizer is suitable for plants such as oil palm tree. It favors granular fertilizer more than the prill because of its enormous tree size. It takes up nutrients slowly compared to other crops. And next, we're going to discuss how and when we are going to apply this fertilizer. And we all know that this fertilizer focuses on potassium and trace elements. It is recommended to apply on the fruiting stage. Not just potassium doing its job to increase the weight of the fruit, but also the boron helps to improve the overall metabolism, flowering rate. Magnesium helps to maintain the tree greener leaves. And of course, this fertilizer works perfectly on paddy, corn, cucumber and other cash crops. However, we still have other cheaper alternatives such as 13-13-21, 12-12-17-2 to do its job right. And another thing is cash crops usually take up nutrients faster than big trees. So in this case, prill one is more favorable than the granular one. For the application rates, you can refer to the boxes shown above. Be informed that the application rate for oil palm tree is different from the cash crops. So as a verdict, what can we say about this fertilizer? It is not well known by many, but it is sure have some unique features to attract users. It has exceptional potassium content alongside with trace elements. Qualities with minor compromises, and most importantly, it offers more than a reasonable price point. With its granular structure, it is a long-lasting fertilizer, even though it only favors some of the plants. Anyway, it is a good choice as replacement of other fertilizers, at which most are out of the stock due to global shortages. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. I'll see you on the next video.